Just walking in a forest, just walking in a forest, just... Mountain Boy! Mountain Boy, get over here!
Stinky Bog Bear, what's wrong?
I have great news. I'm a rock daddy!
Huh?
I found this baby rock on the ground. Someone has to raise her.
Oh, Bog Bear. You can't be that rock's father, because it already has a family. We should find them.
How are we supposed to find them in this forest?
Good point. I guess we'll just have to wait for her family to come back and find her.
Yeah, so what do we do until then?
Be the best rock babysitters ever. Being a rock babysitter is hard. Just like a rock.
We're so bad at this. I'm a bad rock daddy. The baby rock won't eat and won't walk. It hasn't slept. Just look at the bags under its eyes.
Those aren't bags. They're cracks.
Cracks? That's even worse. Oh, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna do?
Bog Bear, you have to stay calm. Because I'm gonna freak out. We need an adult.
We live in the mountains. Where are we gonna find one of those?
Work, everybody. Rocky, more drums. Saul, less drums. Limey, perfect as always, no notes.
Mountain Man John!
Oh, hey Mountaineers. You caught me in the middle of rehearsal.
Rehearsal? With who?
My rock band. Rock band. You get it? Because they're a band and there's rocks? Alright, well Mountain Boy, what can I help you with?
We have an emergency. The Stinky Bog Bear found a baby rock and we're babysitting it, but we're doing so bad.
It won't eat. It doesn't coo when I cuddle it.
Bog Bear, you know that's a pebble, right? Not a baby rock. Rocks don't eat and they don't have families.
Don't say that. She can hear you.
Rocks also don't have ears.
I guess I have more to learn about you, baby rock.
Again, not a baby.
If it doesn't have a family, then where do baby rocks come from, Mountain Man John?
Oh, okay. Ugh. Well, I guess you two are old enough for the talk. Rocks are part of the rock cycle.
The rock cycle?
The rock cycle is a dynamic, continuous cycle in which rocks are constantly being formed, broken down, and reformed again over time using materials such as lava, minerals, shells, other rocks, and more over thousands of years.
So you mean this baby rock is actually a grandma rock?
Yeah, kind of.
Then I guess you don't need our help, baby rock.
Yeah, I guess not. Can I have a moment?
Take your time.
Time to let you go, baby rock.
They grow up so fast. Mountain Man John, what else don't we know about rocks?
Well, did you know that rocks come in different shapes, sizes, and colors?
This mystery just keeps getting deeper and deeper.
Rocks can be tiny pebbles or grains of sands, or huge like mountains. They can be all different kinds of colors. They can be earth tones like browns and grays, or they can be vibrant blues and pinks like sapphires and diamonds.
Ooh, those are pretty. Where can we find those?
Ugh, probably one of those rich houses with the gates around them where they charge you admission to get in and they have the dinosaur bones.
Are you talking about a museum, Bog Bear?
Huh, they even have a fancy name.
Hi, Mountaineers. Let's try a Mentos Glacier experiment. Let's see what's inside our rock box. You'll need a 2-liter bottle of Coca-Cola, Mentos, and a Glacier Tube. So you can get this Glacier Tube on Amazon. Check with your parents. Open up the Mentos. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 Mentos. With the glacier tube, you're gonna pull this red knob out. And then let's load up our Mentos. 1, 2, 3. Let's push the red knob back in to secure our Mentos. You see, it didn't fall. Now for the fun part. So we're gonna open the Coke bottle. Let's twist this on. Yeah! I'm so excited about this, guys. Are you ready? So on the count of three, we're gonna pull the knob away from the Coke bottle so the Mentos will drop into the soda. 1, 2, 3! This is so cool! Wow, guys, that was really fun. Make sure you check with your parents before you do this experiment at home.
That's a rock. 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 If you see it on the ground and it looks small and round, that's a rock. That's a rock.
If it's made from stone or granite and you find it on this planet,
that's a rock. That's a rock. You can find them at the beach or you can find them on your street. That's a rock. That's a rock.
If it comes from shells of lava, minerals like quartz or mica,
that's a rock. 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 That's a... That's a rock. That's a rock. That's a rock. That's a rock!
Mountaineers, I shouldn't have fun playing with rocks today with Mountain Boy and Stinky Bog Bear. But you know what? All that rock talk got me thinking about a friend I used to have who was as strong as rocks. But he had a secret. And his story is right here in Tall Corgi Tales Volume 1. Let's check it out. It's called Vindeford the Viking.
Vindeford the Viking. Written by T.C. Littles. Illustrated by Rami. Vindeford was the fiercest, most intimidating, most burly Viking in his entire village. He was so big that when he walked, his shadow turned the village to night. All the townsfolk had heard of Vindeford and his legendary feats. Vindeford was so strong, he could punch a hole in a lake. He was bold. He could fight an army in only a bath towel. He was so terrifying that monsters checked under their bed for him. Vindeford was the most Vikingest Viking there was. But Vindeford had a terrible secret. He loved to bake cakes. There wasn't a cake in the world he couldn't bake. Strawberry shortcake, pineapple upside down cake, mint blueberry chip cheesecake, and his favorite, brutal berry pound cake. Vindeford could make them all, and his chocolate ganache epic. But Vindeford knew that if any of the townsfolk discovered how much he loved to bake, they would think he was a big old softy. So Vindeford hid his delicious treats from the world. Until one day, a dragon attacked the village. It had horns sharper than steel, wings more powerful than a hurricane, and scales thicker than old people toenails. It trampled the town. The only person who could defeat it was Vindeford! Vindeford battled the dragon with all his might. Their brawl shook the trees and jostled the moon. But Vindeford was not strong enough to beat the dragon. The dragon continued its rampage.
Vindefort knew he had to do something. If he couldn't beat the dragon, he'd have to lure it away from the village. But how? Then it hit him. His cakes! One whiff of his cake, and the dragon was hypnotized. Vindefort threw the cake so far, even the sun couldn't see where it went. The dragon chased after it and away from the village. Vindefort had done it. He had saved the village. But now all of the villagers knew his shameful secret. Vindefort was great at baking cakes. The townsfolk were outraged. Nobody cared that he was the greatest Viking ever. How could he keep his amazing cakes from the townsfolk? He was even more legendary than they thought. Vindefort couldn't believe it. The villagers didn't judge him for baking cakes. They loved him for it. So Vindefort learned a very important lesson that day. It's okay to be the world's greatest Viking. And to bake cakes, too. The end.